come join us here at the CabaRay.
That's the Ray Stevens CabaRay and Showroom right here in West Nashville. We're easy to find at the Charlotte Avenue exit off I-40 West. It's the place in Nashville for a special entertainment and dining experience. There's great food, all your favorite wines and mixed drinks, a fun piano bar where you can sing along and dance. And there's the Ray Stevens Show, where I'll sing all my biggest hits with Nashville's best musicians and singers. So whether it's a special date night, entertaining friends and family, or you're just coming out to sing along in the piano bar, whatever your reason, the CabaRay is a fun place to enjoy a full night of entertainment. And the parking is free. So come see me, Ray Stevens, at the CabaRay. Call 615-327-4630 or go to raystevenscabaret.com. Make your plans now.
From the Ray Stevens Studios in the heart of Nashville's Music Row in Music City, USA, it's Ray Stevens
CabaRay Nashville.
My heart keeps going back to Nashville. That's the only place for me. My love is waiting there in Nashville. Nashville, Tennessee.
With Ray's guest, Leroy Van Dyke.
And the A-Team.
Boogity, boogity, here he comes again. It's Ray Stevens.
Thank you. Now everybody knew his name, from Jacksonville to Bangor, Maine, and there never was a wilder child around. Some would say it was just an act, but I tell you it was a natural fact. I ain't never seen nobody drunk as Cooter Brown. Then our Cooter was born on New Year's Eve, and his mama was mad cause his daddy was asleep, and the boy's real lucky just to be alive. Yeah, cause he'll get real stoned, sing and shout, and every bar he's in, they'll throw him out. Got a tattoo on his arm, said, please don't let me drive. Boy, you Cooter this, Cooter that. Let me tell you where it's at when it comes to juking and getting down. They can't nobody do it like Cooter Brown. You Cooter in, Cooter out, laugh and sing and jump and shout. And you can Cooter up and you can Cooter down, but I bet you can't do it like Cooter Brown. No. Now Cooter never had a wife. He preferred to live the single life. Besides, ain't none of y'all gals would have stood for all that. Cause Cooter loved the finer things like Charlie Daniels and diamond rings, but he spent all his money on Charlie's brother Jack. Now even though he's getting old, he still likes whiskey and rock and roll. Sometimes I'm wondering if it will end at all. Yeah, cause Cooter Brown still comes around. He'll slip and stagger and stumble around, but you can watch all night, you'll never see him fall. Whoa, you Cooter this, Cooter that. But let me tell you where it's at when it comes to juking and getting down. They can't nobody do it like Cooter Brown. You can Cooter in, Cooter out, laugh and sing and jump and shout. And you can Cooter up and you can Cooter down, but I bet you can't do it like Cooter Brown. Now when Cooter dies, meets his maker, he can go ahead and bypass the undertaker, cause you see, he's been embalmed since 1965. Oh, he'll be riding on that glory train with a blowed out liver and a refried brain to that big dry out clinic up in the sky. Yeah, you Cooter this, Cooter that. Let me tell you where it's at when it comes to juking, getting down. They can't nobody do it like Cooter Brown. You Cooter in, Cooter out, laugh and dance and jump and shout. You Cooter up, Cooter down, but I bet you can't do it like Cooter Brown. Have mercy. Woo! Thank you. I moved to Nashville in 1962, January 2nd, to take a job with Mercury Records, working in the A&R department. Just 18 days after I moved up here, I recorded Ahab the Arab at 10 o'clock one morning of January 20th, and at 2 o'clock that same day, This gentleman recorded one of his big hits. Here he is, Leroy Van Dyke, ladies and gentlemen. Did that make any sense at all?
I don't remember that far back. Mm-hmm. And all the other people involved are dead now.
How did you get started in this business?
Well, once upon a time, I camped out in Korea in a squad tent for a year. And the words and the music to a song started coming to me out of the air. Now, you're a songwriter. You're a professional songwriter. I wrote one song and quit while I was ahead. But this song started coming to me, and I kept ignoring it. About the fourth time it came to me, I said, somebody's trying to tell me something. So I went back to my tent and wrote it down. It's a true story about a man, possibly the best purebred livestock auctioneer that ever walked, a man named Ray Sims. And came back from Korea, went to Chicago, and I just got on a talent contest and lost. But before I got out of the studio, the telephone was ringing. And within 2 weeks, we had the record out. Within 3 months, we'd sold 1 million records. And the song was Auctioneer, and that's how it started.
You remember that, folks? Auctioneer?
So the short answer to how I got in the business, it was a fluke.
I wrote Ahab the Arab the night before the session because I was in a panic. We were living in a little one-room apartment here. I just moved up here. It's all we could afford. The baby was sleeping in the bottom dresser drawer. And I said, I got to get out of here. And I had a session booked the next morning, so I'm going to write a hit. And I wrote and recorded Ahab the Arab the next morning. Sure enough, it got me out of that one-room apartment.
I guess it did.
That was a star-struck day because I could have hit that morning. You could have hit 2 o'clock.
Same musicians. Yeah, the same group of musicians.
Yeah, and at 6 o'clock that same day, Joe Dowell cut Wooden Heart, mm-hmm. which was a big hit. Wow.
And he sold 1 million, and you sold 1 million, and I sold 1 million or two. I don't know how many.
Yeah. Shelby Singleton was a producer on all those songs, yes. all those records. Yes. And bless his heart, he's the guy that gave me the job at Mercury.
Well, he's the guy that put me on record. And I was on the Ozark Jubilee with Red Foley. I'd already done my run-through on the show at the Ozark Jubilee. Somebody tapped me on the shoulder and said, who are you recording for? And I said, nobody. I'm looking. I turned around, and he said, I'll record you. It was Shelby Singleton.
Yeah.
And Walk On By was the second song I cut for him.
Yeah.
He was good for me.
Oh, yeah. He's been good for a lot of people.
And Jerry Kennedy, of course.
Oh, yeah.
He was a guitar player.
Kennedy has played guitar on a lot of hit records, including Ahab the Arab and several others of mine. And, of course, for Leroy also. We were talking also, to digress about the song Walk On By, how you found the song. And you were shopping among the publishers here in Nashville to see what they had.
I had a Harlan Howard song that got in the charts, made it to number 17, and just sat there for a while. And Jerry said, we better be looking for another song. And went to Gary Walker's office. That was Bill Lowry's...
My mentor, Lowry
your
Music.
Your mentor, yeah.
Right?
The office here in Nashville. And he played me a lot of stuff, and it was, okay, what else you got? What else you got? What else you got? He said, I got one more song, but I won't play it for you. I said, why not? He said, it's not finished. I said, let me hear it. He said, no, I won't play it for you because it's not finished. I almost had to arm wrestle him. But he finally conceded, and he played the song, and sure enough, it wasn't ready. It sounded like it had been recorded in a garage with an out-of-tune piano and a Webcore wire recorder or something like that. And the voice wasn't the best in the world. And they went through and they said, just walk on by. And I started to say, what else you got? He said, wait on the corner. I said, I want it. He said, but it's not finished. I said, well, let's finish it. So I rearranged the first verse a little bit, rearranged the chorus a little bit. And Gary Walker took it home that night and wrote the second verse because the writer, Kendall Hayes, had run out of gas and he couldn't think of a second verse. And so that's where the song came from.
When you got a good idea like that.
Stroke of luck.
It'll write itself if it has to. Why don't you sing that song for us?
I'll try to remember the words, yeah.
I'll try to back you up here.
Okay, don't hurt me any.
If I see you tomorrow on some street in town, pardon me if I don't say hello. I belong to another,
It wouldn't look so good to know someone I'm not supposed to know. Just walk on by, wait on the corner. I love you, but we're strangers when we meet. Just walk on by, wait on the corner. I love you, but we're strangers when we meet. In a dimly lit corner at a place outside of town, tonight we'll try to say goodbye again. But I know it's not over. I'll call tomorrow night. I can't let you go, so why pretend? Just walk on by, wait on the corner. I love you, but we're strangers when we meet. Just walk on by, wait on the corner. I love you, but we're strangers when we meet. I love you, but we're strangers.
Hi, this is Ray Stevens with some great news. My CabaRay gift shop has gone digital. You no longer have to drive to Tennessee to see all the stuff we have for you to enjoy and buy. Take your time and take a nice long look around at all the ball caps, t-shirts, monkeys and squirrels. We have keychains, cups, mouse pads, and books, CDs, DVDs, and so much more. Everything we have in the gift shop is now available to you here online. So fill up that shopping cart.
Do you have something you want to sell? I got your man, Leroy Van Dyke.
Hey, boy, watch your hip over there, and what are you going to give for me? I'm at 25 to get 30 now, 5 for a bid to 5 and a $40 on the behind there. There was a boy in Arkansas who would listen to his ma when she told him he should go to school. He'd sneak away in the afternoon, take a little walk, then pretty soon you'd find him at the local auction barn. He'd stand and listen carefully, then pretty soon he began to see how the auctioneer could talk so rapidly. He said, oh my, it's do or die, I've got to learn that auction cry. Gotta make my mark and be an auctioneer. $25 bid and I'll put it on a 30, but give me 30, make a 30, bid the bomb, put it on a bid, give me 30, hooter, bid a $30 bid. $30 bid and now 35, bid, give me 35, to make a 35, to bid a 35, who would have bid another $35 bid? As time went on, he did his best, and all could see he didn't jest. He practiced calling his bull fighting day. His pap would find him behind the barn, just to working up an awful storm, and he tried to imitate the auctioneer. Then his pap said, son, would this stand to have a mediocre man selling things at auction using our good name? I'll send you off to auction school, then you'll be nobody's fool. You can take your place among the best. $35 bid, another $40, $40, give me a 40, make a 40, bid on a $40 bid, give me a 40, bid, a $40 bid. $40 bid, and now 45, bid, give me 45, make it a 45, bid, a 45, who would have bid it at a $45 bid? So from that boy who went to school, there grew a man who played it cool. He came back home a full-fledged auctioneer. Then the people came from miles around to hear him make that rhythmic sound that filled their hearts with such a happy cheer. His fame spread out from shore to shore. He had all he could do and more. Had to buy a plane to get around. Now he's the tops in all the land. Let Paul can give that man a hand. He's the best of all the auctioneers. $45, $50, $50, $50, $50, $50, $50, $50, $50, $50, $50, $50, $50, $50, $50, $50, $50, $50, $50, $50, $50, $50, $50, $50, $50, $50, $50, $50, $50, $50, $50, $50, $50, $50, $50, $50, $50, $50, $50, $50, $50, $50, $50, $50, $50, $50, $50, $50, $50, $50, $50, $50, $50, $50, $50, $50, $50, $50, $50, $50, $50, $50, $50, $50, $50, $50, $50, $50, $50, $50, $50, $50, $50, $50, $50, $50, $50, $50, $50, $50, $50, $50, $50, $50, $50, $50, $50, $50, $50, $50, $50, $50, $50, $50, $50, $50, $50, $50, $50, $50, $50, $50, $50, $50, $50, $50, $50, $50, $50, $50, $50, $50, $50, $50, $50, $50, $50, $50, $50, $50, $50, $50, $50, $50, $50, $50, $ $50, sold that goat for a $50 bill. Hey, well, all right, sir, open the gate, let him out and walk him, boy. Here we come on lot number 29 in, what are they going to get for? I'm at $600 down here, not 10, not 25, not 35, 50, 60, 70, 85, 90, 90, 90, 90, 90, 90, 90, 90, 90, 90, 90, 90, 90, 90, 90, 90, 90, 90, 90, 90, 90, 90, 90, 90, 90, 90, 90, 90, 90, 90, 90, 90, 90, 90, 90, 90, 90, 90, 90, 90, 90, 90, 90, 90, 90, 90, 90, 90, 90, 90, 90, 90, 90, 90, 90, 90, 90, 90, 90, 90, 90, 90, 90, 90, 90, 90, 90, 90, 90, 90, 90, 90, 90, 90,
90, 90, 90, 90, 90, 90, 90, 90, 90, 90, 90, 90, 90, 90, 90, 90, 90, 90, 90, 90, 90, 90, 90, 90, 90, 90, 90, 90,
I'm really an auctioneer, yes. I went to an auctioneer school right after my junior year of college, and it opened a few gates for me.
Boy, I tell you, I love to hear you guys do that. You know, I got a question for you now.
Okay.
Are you really as young as people say you are?
Oh, I'm younger than they say I am.
Yes. I mean, this man will never be as young as he looks. How old are you?
86.
86.
I was born 1812. What does that figure?
1812.
1812, yes.
Woo. Let me tell you something. I won't come out and live with you, eat what you eat. Boy.
Well, I think, my wife puts formaldehyde in my coffee.
I had a grandpa put gunpowder in his oatmeal every morning, you know, and when he died, he left a 50-foot hole in the hay hire of crematory. Ray Stevens here, and I'm really with the digital music program. Oh, yeah. You can get Ray Stevens' product on all the major platforms. Apple, Spotify, Pandora, Amazon, YouTube, and many others. So why don't you get with the program, too, and get you some Ray Stevens on your smartphone. Or just ask that little black box on the counter. She knows where to find all the Ray Stevens product. Hey, Alexandria. Alabama. What is that girl's name?
Alexa, play songs by Ray Stevens on Spotify.
Ray Stevens from Spotify.
Here's a favorite song of mine from my encyclopedia of recorded comedy music. Dear sir, I write this note to you to tell you of me plight. For at the time of writing, I am not a pretty sight. Me body is all black and blue, me face a deathly gray. And I write this note to tell you why I'm not at work today. While working on the 14th floor, some bricks I had to clear. But to toss them down from such a height was not a good idea. The foreman wasn't very pleased. He is an awkward sod. He said I'd have to cart them down the ladders in me hod. Now shifting all those bricks by hand, it was so very slow. So I hoisted up a barrel and secured a rope below. But in me haste to do the job, I was too blind to see that a barrel full of building bricks is heavier than me. And so when I untied the rope, the barrel fell like lead. And clinging tightly to the rope, I started up instead. I shot up like a rocket, till to my dismay I found that halfway up I met the bloody barrel coming down. Now the barrel broke me shoulder, as to the ground it sped. And when I reached the top, I banged the pulley with me head. I clung on tightly, numb with shock from this almighty blow. And the barrel spilled out half the bricks 14 floors below. Now when those bricks had fallen from the barrel to the floor, I then outweighed the barrel and so started down once more. Still clinging tightly to the rope, me body racked with pain. Halfway down, I met the bloody barrel once again. Now the force of this collision halfway down the office block caused multiple contusions and a nasty state of shock. still clinging tightly to the rope, I fell towards the ground and landed on the broken bricks the barrel had scattered round. Well, I lay there groaning on the ground. I thought I'd passed the worst, but the barrel hit the pulley wheel and then the bottom burst. A shower of bricks rained down on me. I didn't have a hope. And as I lay there bleeding, I let go the bloody rope. The barrel being unsecured then started down once more, and it landed right across me as I lay there on the floor. It broke three ribs and my left arm, and I can only say that I hope you'll understand why Murphy's not at work today. Thank you. Oh yes, that's an old English song, I think, about an Irishman. Now this politician was stumping for votes among the farmers down in South Georgia. And he's talking to one farmer, and these little flies just kept swarming around his head, and he tried to wave them off, but the more he waved, the more they swarmed, until finally he asked the farmer, he said, "What are these things?" And the farmer said, "Well, they're circle flies." And the politician said, "Well, circle flies, why do you call them that?" He said, the farmer said, "Well, they usually circle around a horse's backside." And the politician said, "Now, wait a minute. Are you calling me a horse's backside?" And the farmer said, "Why, no, I'd never do a thing like that. But you can't fool them flies." There's that music again. Time for us to leave, and it's time for me to find a dance partner. How about you, man? Well, thank you. Come on, watch your step.
This program was recorded before a live audience in the Ray Stevens Studios in Nashville, Tennessee. Music City, USA. This is Bill Cody. We'll see you next time.
Come join us here at the CabaRay. That's the Ray Stevens CabaRay and Showroom right here in West Nashville. We're easy to find at the Charlotte Avenue exit off I-40 West. It's the place in Nashville for a special entertainment and dining experience. There's great food, all your favorite wines and mixed drinks, a fun piano bar where you can sing along and dance. And there's the Ray Stevens Show, where I'll sing all my biggest hits with Nashville's best musicians and singers. So whether it's a special date night, entertaining friends and family, or you're just coming out to sing along in the piano bar, whatever your reason, the CabaRay is a fun place to enjoy a full night of entertainment. And the parking is free. So come see me, Ray Stevens, at the CabaRay. Call 615-327-4630 or go to raystevenscabaret.com. Make your plans now.